In this video, I like to show you how you can connect the WKC web UI with your SFTP storage using a certificate. We will do this in Windows, as you can see, and what you need is software like PuTTY generator and WinSCP to access your SFTP storage. I just noted my credentials to access my storage, and we will begin with opening WinSCP and entering our details. Now click login. And now you have to make sure that hidden files are displayed. Click on Options, Preferences, Panels, and Show Hidden Files must be ticked on. Now do a right click, go to New, create a directory, and we call the directory .ssh. Click OK, enter the directory. Okay, now we switch to PuTTY Gen or PuTTY Generator. It is basically an SSH key generator. You can use RSA or also ECDSA. I click on generate and now I have to move my mouse randomly and now I have a generated key. What you should do, you should save your private key with a key phrase. Now I click on conversion and export the OpenSSH key. I created a folder on my desktop and yeah, I call it private key in this key case. What I need now is this part. I just mark it and copy it. And now here back on WinSCP, I create a new file. I call it authorized keys. And now an editor opens up and I paste the just copied public key in it and save it. Now I make sure that the permissions are correct. And now back to WKC, we create an SFTP storage. And again, I need my credentials or even part of it. The username must also be used, but the password is not the password of your username now. It's the password of a just encrypted private key. And we now select the private key on our hard disk. This is the key we just created. And now we can click on directory. And yeah, it's correct, there's nothing in it. So to make sure that we are on the correct storage, I'm going back to WinSCP, back here, and create a new directory, calling it test, cancel it. And now I see the directory, I can select it for my backup, select and continue. I can now give a storage name. And I should select the password here because the encryption of WKC of the backups is now enabled. We are finished now. The SFTP storage is added now and we do not need to use it with password and username. It uses the just created certificate. In case you lose your key, you have to create a new one and repeat this procedure.